A population model with constant birth and death rates is not so interesting or realistic. We get either exponential population growth or decay. So let us refine our model slightly. We will modify our death rate. The death rate becomes larger for bigger populations. While that's not such a strange assumption, this can be caused, for example, due to shortage of food if a population gets really big, and hence enhancing death rates. This small modification leads to the so-called logistic equation, as we'll see in this video. We will also qualitatively explore its solutions already, so let us take a look. So, what do we have? We have our population model dpdt equals beta times p minus delta times p with some initial population, where beta was birth rate and delta death rate. Birth rate, the number of births per person per year, and delta death rate, the number of deaths per person per year. So we set the birth rate just constant, beta to be beta 0, and now we will modify the death rate slightly to be delta 0 again, plus delta 1 times p, where delta 1 is positive. So we get bigger death rate if the populations become big. And of course we have to take beta 0 bigger than delta 0, because if the birth rate is always smaller than the death rate, just the population will just die out. So we set beta 0 bigger than delta 0. So for small populations, population is growing. Let us see, what do we get then? So we plug the beta 0 in and the delta in our dpdt. So we get beta 0 times p minus delta times p. And we simplify a bit. We combine the terms which are linear in a p, so this term is linear in p, and we get a minus delta 0 times p, so the linear term in p, and we have a quadratic term minus delta 1 times p squared. And now we can rewrite this a bit. We take the p times beta 0 minus delta 0 outside of the brackets, then we get a 1, and the second term looks a bit awkward. This term becomes that one. Looks a bit more complicated. And then we choose some different constants. The constant in front is called k, beta 0 minus delta 0. It's the growth rate of the population, effective growth rate, positive, because we took beta 0 to be bigger than delta 0. And this other constant, m, is called the carrying capacity, which should be beta 0 minus delta 0 over delta 1, so reversed. And let's take a look at so-called equilibrium solutions. When do we have a constant population? Well, we have a constant population if dpdt equals 0, so and there's neither growth nor decay. When do we have dpdt equals 0? Well, we have dpdt over here, so it's 0 if either p equals 0, or if this term equals 0, so if p equals m. So we have equilibrium. If either you have a 0 population, okay, that's sad, but true. Or, and that's different now, if your p is equal to this constant capital M, the carrying capacity. Now, what happens if our population is between 0 and m? Now, if we are between 0 and capital M, our dpdt over here, k is positive, p is positive, and then because p is between 0 and m, 1 is bigger than p over m, so 1 minus p over m is also positive, so the dpdt is bigger than 0, which means that population is increasing. So if p is between 0 and m, we get an increasing population. Now what happens if p is bigger than m? Well, still, the first two terms over here are positive, but now p bigger than m, so p over m is bigger than 1, so now the p over m wins from the 1, so this term over here will become negative. So that means that dpdt becomes negative, so p is decreasing in that case. So if your population is bigger than capital M, your population is decreasing. You can summarize this graphically. Well, first you draw a diagram with the t on the horizontal axis and p on the vertical axis, and then you can put in the diagram first the equilibrium population. So if p equals m for all t, we stay at capital M. Now what happens if you start somewhere below your capital M, say over here at t equals 0? What happens to the population? Well, in that case, you are in this case, so you know your population is increasing. So if t goes on, your capital M will become bigger. So your PS function of t will be something like that. But you will stay below the equilibrium population, of course, because solutions cannot intersect. Then what happens if we start bigger? So for example, we said over there. Then we know that the p is bigger than capital M, so your population will be decreasing. So your p of t behaves something like this as a decreasing function. So something like that happens. So you see, even without solving explicitly analytically what the solution is, you can already see qualitatively from the figure over here what happens to your population as a function of time. If you are at capital M, you stay there. If you are above zero but below your capital M, your population will grow until you get very close to capital M. And if you are above your carrying capacity, then your population will gradually decrease until you are very close to your capital M. So you got already lots of information about your p of t, even without solving the problem explicitly analytically.